In politics, it's not just lying or stealing that will get you in trouble or cost you your job. Sometimes it's simply telling the truth. So Liz Mayer is, or I should say was, the social media strategist for the Governor Scott Walker presidential campaign. But then she accidentally did something that destroyed her entire career. She told the truth. Here's what happened. She is a prolific tweeter, and she tweeted things like, Iowans are addicted to ethanol, and you know, these aren't her exact words, but it's essentially a horrible policy. They need to get off their addiction. Now, here's the thing about ethanol and giving corn producers lots of money to then turn it into fuel. At this stage, basically, all environmentalists and economists agree it's a horrible policy. The only reason we have that policy is that politicians like to pander to Iowa voters, and Iowa has an outplaced influence in the presidential campaigns. Liz Mayer, again, I'm not being partisan here or even ideological. Liberals and conservatives, Democrats and Republicans, as long as they're not running for president, agree that our ethanol policies are crazy. And for this, Liz Mayer was pilloried. Now, she also said that some of the politicians in Iowa, she was referencing Representative Steve King in particular, are embarrassing the party. Again, this is not an ideological statement. Lots and lots of Republicans agree that when Steve King gets out and says that, you know, immigrants with calves the size of cantaloupes are trundling along carrying all their drugs, he seems like an anti-immigrant xenophobic fool, and he's hurting the party. Again, there's widespread agreement with Liz Mayer on this, Democrats, Republicans, liberals, and conservatives. She was simply stating the truth. The next thing that really got her into big trouble is when she said, the sooner Iowa isn't the first and controlling everything for the party nominating process, the better. Again, widespread agreement across the political spectrum in both parties that Iowa is not a particularly good place to test candidates. It's especially a problem for Republicans because they are perceived as a party that's anti-white, anti-immigrant, anti-brown, anti-different, and Iowa is much whiter than the rest of the country. So those three things, speaking out the truth, cost her her job. She was fired within, or she stepped down, however you want to phrase it. She was gone after 24 hours. So it's all well and good to criticize politicians for being liars and hypocrites, and when they're caught stealing, as Representative Aaron Schock was with his 90,000 bogus miles of gas reimbursement. But let's not forget, politics is a tough business because it's an area where you can see your entire career vaporized, not just for lying, but for telling the truth.